Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'm going to give you some area type text tips you got to know if you work with Adobe Illustrator. And the last tip, well, let's just say it solved one of my biggest pet peeves about area type, so stick with me till the end to find out what that is. And if along the way you learn something new, I'd really appreciate a thumbs up and ask you to consider subscribing to my channel so you don't miss any of my future tutorials. Now let's move to a blank document and get started. Area type is text that's placed inside of an object in Illustrator. Now the object can be a rectangle, in fact it typically is, but it can also be a circle or any other shape. We'll talk about circles and rectangles in this video, but what you learn is going to apply to any other shape as well. We create our text box by coming over and getting the type tool. It's a keyboard shortcut T. I'll drag out a rectangle, which Illustrator is going to turn into my text box. And inside it, I have placeholder text that is our area type. Now, the default setting is Myriad Pro 12 points, which is almost never what I'm working on for my project. I could show you how to go into the systems settings of your software and change that default, but I won't even do it on my own computer. I think I have an easier solution, and I'll show you what I do. I just click on the artboard for some point type. This doesn't have any text box around it, and with that selected, I'll come over and let's type in 24 points and press the return key. Illustrator changes the point type text, but more importantly, it's going to remember that 24 points. And so if I come over here and delete the point type and the text box, get the type tool again and drag out another rectangle, it remembers 24 points, and that's what it gives me. Now to resize my text, I'm not able to do that with the text box. I'll get the selection tool and show you what happens. I'll grab hold of an anchor and begin to drag, and the only thing that happens is the size of the text box changes, but the text remains at 24 points. Now you may have seen text resized by pulling on an anchor, but that's with point type. So if I have point type, I can grab an anchor here, hold down the shift key, and increase the size of the text, and the shift key keeps it from losing its proportion. But that's not the kind of text we're working on here, so I'll delete that. I have to change this text manually. I'm going to change this text box back, and then let's click on the artboard to deselect it. Now it looks okay here, but in some instances I might want a stroke around my text. So let's select this and see what happens if we come over and give it a stroke. So I'll click on the stroke color icon and choose black, but instead of adding the stroke to my text box, it added it to my text, which is not what I wanted. So I'll click none to remove the stroke and then click on the artboard to close out the swatches panel. I'm going to have to do something different. Right now, the text is selected. You can tell that because it's underlined and the text box around it is selected. I'm going to click on the artboard to deselect those, then come over and get the direct selection tool, which is going to allow me to just select the text box. Now I've got to be very careful so I don't select my text. I just want the text box. I'm going to come right in between these lines. I found that's about the easiest place to select the text box. It's hard to come over on the right side because you can't tell exactly where that text box is. So I'm going to click here and I've selected just the text box. I have the blue line here. I don't have blue lines under my text. So with that selection, I'll come over to the properties panel in the appearance area and click on the ellipsis. And here I'm able to change the color of the stroke. I'll click on the stroke color icon, We'll add black here. I'll leave everything else the same and close this out and click on the artboard to deselect it. And here I now have a black stroke around my text. Now the formatting doesn't look very good yet, but we'll get to that in a minute. What I want to do is select some of the text here, and I'm going to copy it and then paste it here. And as I do, you see I have this little red square in the bottom right-hand area of that text box, which is my overflow warning. And it's telling me that I have more text than I have text box. And I can correct this in different ways, depending on what the needs of my project happen to be. I'll come over and get the selection tool, and solution number one is to double click on this square blue box that's at the bottom of the text box, and when I do, I'll be turning on auto resize. So I'll double click here, and Illustrator automatically resizes the text box to fit all of the text. That works fine unless your text box needs to be a specific size. So I'll undo that move. I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut Command Z to do that. And I'm actually going to add a little bit more text. So we'll paste in some more. And I want to give us a heading here. So we'll type, this is the top. Now I'll get the selection tool, and we have our red overflow warning again. This time, what I'm going to do is click right on the very center of it. And if I click it in the right place, I'm going to end up with some very small text that's attached to my cursor. You can see it here on the right side. No way can you read it, but trust it's there. And I'm going to create another rectangle, and this is going to be another text box. And Illustrator is going to link the first text box to the second text box. That's what this blue line indicates. And so the text now flows from the first box to the second box. Problem is, I still have more text than text box. So I'm going to undo that move, and we're going to try one more thing. I'll get the rectangle tool and drag out a rectangle. I'm going to change the fill color here, and then make a copy of this rectangle and drag it over to this side. Now come back to the overflow button, click here. I didn't get the text this time. Let me come back and try it again. Got to click right on the very center. I have it now. I'll click on the rectangle, and Illustrator links these text boxes, but I still have too much text. So let me click again, grab some more text, and click on this rectangle I drew here. And Illustrator has finally found enough room for all the text, but the problem is the order. So we start out in the middle, go to the right, and then we're linked all the way back to the left. And that's not going to work either. I want to get rid of the text in the left box because it's out of order. So I need to go to the box it's connected to, and that would be this one right here. And I'll double click on this little arrow. So I'll double click, and it pulls all of that text from the left side back to the second rectangle. Okay, well, that takes care of that problem. But how am I going to get these in order? I don't want to have to start moving all of the boxes around on the artboard. Well, actually, it's very simple. I'm going to come to the first box because I want this text to move to the left. Theoretically, if I move this to the left, everything else is going to flow to the right. So to do that, I've got to create a link from this middle box to the box on the left. Now, I don't come down and click on the bottom right. I click on the top left, and I have this little square that's underneath the anchor. If you click on the anchor, it's not going to do anything. But if I click here on the little box and get in the right spot, I have some more text. I'll click on the rectangle to the left, and Illustrator moves the text from the center to the left, and then everything else is flowing nicely, and that's exactly what I wanted. Now let's quickly delete these and see what happens with circles. I'm going to drag out a circle, change its color, and then we'll drag out two more, get the type tool, and click here in the center, and then I'm going to add some more text. Then I'll click right here on the little red square. It's not on the bounding box, it's going to be on the circle, but it's pretty much in the same location. We'll click here and move our text here. The link is created between the two. I already know what's going to happen if I click here and come to this circle. So I'm going to go back to this first circle, click here. Now this little square isn't on the bounding box, it's on the circle itself, but I'll click here. I get my text and click on this circle here. Illustrator moves everything to where it flows from left to right. So you can see how with any shape, you're going to be able to get the text to flow from object to object quite easily. Okay, I'm going to delete these circles and come back to a text box. And I'm going to get the direct selection tool. I want to quickly add a stroke around this. So we'll change to black. Now I want to show you how we can format this to look a little nicer. I'll select the text and come up to type and down to area type options. And I've got a dialog box with a lot of options here. Some of them are more useful than others. So I can change the width and the height of the text box. I don't want to do that now, but I could type in an exact size, which in a lot of situations would be very useful. The next section though, the rows and the columns. Let me show you what happens if I increase the number of rows. Illustrator is calling this section, and this section individual rows. And then on the columns, if I increase that, you see that we're adding columns. The gutter is the space in between these. Now it looks really nice, but you can't treat these as individual cells because the text is simply going to flow from one to the other. And I have found exactly zero uses for this option. So if you can find some way to use this, leave a comment and let me know what it is, because I'm at a total loss. And we're going to move these numbers back to one. The next section, though, is very useful. This next section allows us to create an offset or a margin around the inside of the text box, and that's going to make the formatting look so much nicer. So I'm going to increase the size of the inset spacing, and let's try 0.125 inches. You can see I have this little space around here. The other things that I can do are change the alignment. Now, this is not the alignment of the text itself, but the placement of the text inside the text box. I just have too much text to show you how that works. So let me just delete some text here, and then we'll come back, select this, and let's see how this works. Right now, with the setting on top, the text is at the top of the text box. I can center it. I can bring it to the bottom, or I can justify it, which is going to spread it out inside that text box. Let's bring it back to top. Text flow is for those rows and columns, which I'm not going to use. Auto size was where we double clicked here and the text box automatically resized to the text. We won't do that again. So I'm just going to click OK. Now let's talk about something people ask about a lot, and that's hyphenation. Where is it? How do you turn it on? How do you turn it off? This is another one of the functions where you can actually go into the systems part of your software and turn it off permanently if you never want it. But as soon as I do that, I'd probably find a reason I had to turn it back on. So I just deal with hyphenation, which isn't very often, on a need to change basis. To change your hyphenation, it's really quite simple. Select your text, come over to the properties panel in the paragraph area, click on the ellipsis, and here's the little checkbox. Click the box to turn it on and click the box again to turn it off. It is that simple. Now for some time savers that I use all the time, and that would be keyboard shortcuts when I need to change my text into a bold font, an italic font, or underline it. And you're going to want to remember these if you work with text a lot in Illustrator. Let me double click on this word to select it. To make it bold, I'll press Shift Command B. To underline it, Shift Command U. And to make it italic, Shift Command I. I use the same keys to turn those off. So Shift Command I, Shift Command U, and Shift Command B. And we're back to the way we were. Now, even though this video is about area type text, I do want to show you how you can easily change your text from area type to point type if the situation arises. All you have to do is come to the little round blue circle that's on the right side of the text box and double click, and Illustrator has converted your text now to point type, which means I can drag this around. Now remember, hold the shift key down so your text stays in proportion. And that's how you can switch from area type to point type. And then if you want to go back to the area type, double click the circle again. And we are back to regular area type text. Now for the last tip, which I told you solved one of my biggest pet peeves, I'm going to first prepare our text. So I'm going to select this and go back to the 12 point Myriad Pro, which is the default setting, and then get the selection tool and delete this text. Then I'll get the type tool again, and that's keyboard shortcut T. I already told you that when I create a text box, the text is very seldom the right size for me, and it just drives me nuts having to resize it, make it larger, and then I have overflow, or I have to delete anyway. It's just a big mess. So if it bugs you as much as it bugs me, I will tell you there is a way to get rid of that lorem ipsum placeholder text forever. I'm going to come up to Illustrator, go to Settings, and over and down to Type. The third box from the bottom says Fill New Type Objects with Placeholder Text. I don't want that. I'm going to uncheck it and say OK. I'll delete that text, and let's get the text box as well. And drag out another one, and look what I have. Text box, no lorem ipsum. Now it's hard to see, but my cursor is blinking in the top left corner, and all I have to do is begin typing just as if there was some placeholder text there, but I don't have to mess with resizing lines and lines and lines of text that I didn't want. I love this, and maybe you will too. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video and learned some things about using area type in Illustrator. I'm going to leave a link to the other videos I've created on text and on fonts, and you can check those out if you're interested, and I'll also be adding some more as time goes on. Again, I want to invite you to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.